Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Just very quickly, a short reminder, inshallah, if you can stay for just a couple of minutes, inshallah. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Wal Aqibatul Muttaqeen, Wa Salatu Wa Salamu Ala Rasulil Kareem, Wa Ala Alihi Wa Sahbihi Ajma'een, Amma Ba'd. Actually, Brother Haroon has asked me to do the reminder in Urdu, then summarize in English, and then it has to be quick. I think it's a very difficult task. Okay, let me do it in English. My English is easy anyway, inshallah. When it comes to the month of Ramadan, our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to increase his acts of worship, including his night prayer. And if you look at the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will not find that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started or initiated any new good deed or any new act of worship only during the month of Ramadan. Whether it is reading of the Quran or performing the night prayer or fasting. With regards to the fasting, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to fast every Monday and every Thursday throughout the year, before Ramadan and after Ramadan. When it comes to the night prayer, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to perform the night prayer every single night. When it comes to reading the Quran, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to read the Quran during the day and during the night as well. It was only that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to increase the acts of worship. Obviously, with regards to the fasting, he would fast all 29 and 30 days. When it comes to reading of the Quran, he would increase the amount of his recitation within the month of Ramadan. Likewise, when it came to the night prayer, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also increased the night prayer. When we say he increased the night prayer, he did not increase the number of rak'at. Rather, he increased the qiyam. He prolonged the qiyam. He prolonged the recitation. He would prolong the ruku and sujood, and there are a number of evidences. One of them is what is reported by our mother Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. She was once asked a question about the night prayer of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Ramadan. So the person who asked the question, he said, كَيْفَ كَانَ صَلَاتُ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi Ramadan? How was the prayer of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, night prayer of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam during Ramadan? And she replied, Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha said, ma kana yazidu fi ramadan wa la fi ghayrihi ala 11 rak'atan. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would never increase in Ramadan or outside Ramadan more than, he would not pray more than 11 rak'at. So in Ramadan and outside Ramadan he would pray only 11 rak'at. And then our mother Aisha radiallahu ta'ala, she explained how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would pray his night prayer in Ramadan. She said, "Kana yusalli arba'an, fala tas'al an husnihin wa tulihin." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would pray, he would perform 4 rak'at of night prayer. And when it comes to the length and the beauty of those 4 rak'at, la tas'al, do not ask. Don't ask about the beauty and the length of those 4 rak'at. And then he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would take a short break and then he would perform another 4 rak'at. Again, she said, لا تسأل عن حسنهن وطولهن. Never ask about the beauty and the length of those 4 rak'at. And then he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would conclude his night prayer with the witr prayer. This is one of the ahadith that explains the night prayer of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam continued performing his night prayer every single Ramadan. And one of the Ramadans, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he led the Isha prayer. He led Isha prayer in the masjid, and then he asked our mother Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha to set a prayer mat for him just next to the door of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha that used to open inside the masjid of Nabawi, the masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So she laid the prayer mat for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he sallallahu alaihi wasallam started his night prayer straight after Isha. And when he sallallahu alaihi wasallam started the night prayer, the companions ridwanullahi alaihim who prayed with him Isha prayer, they also joined him. So it became a congregation. The Prophet ﷺ, as usual, according to his daily routine, he ﷺ continued his night prayer, and he went until he ﷺ spent 1/3 of the night in his night prayer. 1/3. And I don't think we ever tried 1/3 ever in our life. Or probably during one of the last 10 or nine nights, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us tawfiq. So the companions, Ridwanullah and Ajma'in, they joined the Prophet sallam, and they really enjoyed the salah with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And just imagine who is leading the night prayer? Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imam is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the companions are the congregation. They really enjoyed the night prayer of Rasulullah sallam, and this was particularly the 23rd night of the month of Ramadan. 23rd night. That can be one of the nights that has the possibility to be the night of the decree, the night of the Qadr, Laylatul Qadr. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he led this way, and then the companion Ridwanullah and Majma'in, they obviously completed the salah, they went back home. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha says that next morning, the companion Ridwanullah and Alayhi Majma'in, they were discussing amongst themselves about the night prayer of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they were looking forward to joining the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for the next night. But on 24th night, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam led Salatul Isha, and then he went back home and he never came out. The companion Ridwanullah alaihi majma'in, they kept waiting in the masjid and they left. And then next night, which is the 25th night, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam led Salatul Isha, and then he sallallahu alaihi wasallam looked at the companions, and he sallallahu alaihi wasallam knew that they were waiting for him to lead them in Salatul Layl, in the night prayer. So he sallallahu alaihi wasallam started the night prayer, and the companion Ridwanullah al-Majma'in, they joined him. But this night, 25th night, he sallallahu alaihi wasallam prolonged the night prayer, and his recitation, his ruku, his sujood, it was longer than the night of the 23rd. It was longer, to the level that our mother Aisha radiallahu ta'ala says that the Prophet ﷺ spent 2/3 of the night in his qiyam, in his night prayer. And obviously again, the companions, Ridwanullah al-Majma'in, they again enjoyed the night prayer. Although it was long, just imagine 2/3 of the night have gone in the night prayer. But the companion, Ridwanullah alayhi majma'in, they really enjoyed the prayer. And then when the Prophet ﷺ concluded the salah, the companions Ridwanullah alayhi majma'in, they approached him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they said, "Lawla naffaltana baqiyata laylatina hadhihi." O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, why did you not complete the whole night in the night prayer? And we wish that you would have continued with the night prayer. We were really enjoying the salah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said at that point, "Innahu man qama ma'al imami hatta yansarif kutiba lahu qiyamu layla." He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever performs the night prayer in congregation with the imam until the imam completes the night prayer, he will get the reward of performing the salah for the whole night. Even if you spent only half an hour or 1 hour or 1.5 hour or 2 hours, but you will get the reward of performing the night prayer throughout the night, from Isha until Fajr. And this is actually the hadith, the part of the hadith we take for our own benefit. And there is no harm in it, inshallah. And we hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah Dhul Jalal Ikram gives us that reward. But we tend to forget the whole context of the hadith. When the Prophet ﷺ said this and he gave this glad tiding to the companion and to the whole ummah that whoever performs the night prayer with the imam, he will get the reward of performing the night prayer throughout the night. It was on the 25th night when he ﷺ himself led the companions Ridwanullahi al-Majma'in, and he spent 2/3 of the night in his night prayer. And then it was the 26th night. Again, the Prophet ﷺ did not lead them in congregation. And then it came the 27th night, which is one of the special nights. There are many evidences that the Prophet ﷺ said there is high possibility It is not confirmed. You cannot say for sure that it is the night of the decree or night of the power, Laylatul Qadr. But there is high possibility in 27th night. So this night, again, the companions, Ridwanullahi Alayhim Ajma'een, they gathered in the masjid and they stayed after Salatul Isha. And this time, this was the third night when the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam led them in congregation, the night prayer. The companions, Ridwanullahi Alayhim Ajma'een, they started the night prayer with the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in congregation straight after Salatul Isha. And just imagine this night. This night, the 27th night, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam spent whole night in the night prayer. From Isha until Fajr, very close to the suhoor time, that to the level that Jabir bin Abdullah radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, he says, we were standing in the prayer and we were having the fear in our heart that we might miss the suhoor. There wasn't enough time for us to have suhoor. It was very close to the Fajr time. So he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, spent whole night. And now I would like to ask myself and you, brothers and sisters, did we ever try this type of night prayer in our life? Ever? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to increase his acts of worship. He used to increase the quality, not the quantity. We are always after the, and we always have this dispute whether it's 8 rakat or 20 rakat or 36 rakat. The number doesn't really matter. You have to go by the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. You have to look at the quality. Look at the sunnah of Rasulullah ﷺ. If the Prophet ﷺ wanted, he would have increased the number of rak'at. Even when he was leading the companions, Ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'een, when he spent the whole night. And again, with regards to the night prayer, let me make it very clear. We all believe that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent as a mercy for whole mankind, Muslim and non-Muslim, and particularly for his ummah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had special mercy, and he sallallahu alaihi wasallam would not do anything that could cause a burden, or he did not want to overburden his ummah in any way, any form or shape. He had special mercy for his ummah. But when it came to night prayer, can we say the Prophet ﷺ was not merciful when he led the companions in the first night and he spent one third, and the second night he spent two thirds, and the third night he spent the whole night? Was he not merciful? And nowadays we try to, and we tend to be more merciful than the companions, than the Prophet ﷺ. No. The point is that the actual purpose of the night prayer is not to look for ease and comfort. Rather, if you look at the seerah of Rasulullah ﷺ, the sole purpose of the night prayer is that you tire yourself for the sake of Allah. You have to get tired. But unfortunately, we always complain, no, it's too long. Why Imam has taken too long? And even if it is long, the Imam, I'm sure Imam always, if it is the long recitation, it's only recitation or the Qiyam. But as for Ruku and Sujood, it's never so long. But if you look at the seerah of Rasulullah ﷺ, our mother Aisha, Jabir ibn Abdullah, Abdullah ibn Abbas, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhum, all these companions, Ridwanullahi al-Majma'in, they reported that the Ruku and the Sujood of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and the length of the Ruku and the Sujood of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, was equal to the length of his Qiyam. The length of the Ruku and Sujood was equal to the length of the Qiyam. So that is why the point is, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, that we should follow the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. I'm not saying that we should do the Qiyam this way every single night, but we are very close to the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan, in which the Prophet ﷺ would increase his night prayer by prolonging the Qiyam, by prolonging the Ruku, by prolonging the Sujood, and making a lot of dua in the position of Sujood, in Ruku, and in Qiyam as well. So continue following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And finally, when it comes to the witr prayer, The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam prayed the witr in different ways. One of them is the way we perform the witr prayer today, that he sallallahu alaihi wasallam would pray all three witr together, all three witr together without sitting after the second rak'ah. And then the other way is that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to pray two rak'ah. He would sit down after the second rak'ah. He would read the complete tashahhud. He would conclude those two rak'at with salam. He would finish them, and then he would stand up for another rak'ah. Altogether, three rak'at, but he would break them with salam and with tashahhud. And sometime the Prophet ﷺ used to pray five rak'at altogether. When you pray five rak'at, he ﷺ would not sit after second rak'ah or after fourth rak'ah, rather he would sit only in the final rak'ah. Sometime he would pray all together seven rak'at witr. Okay, again, if you pray seven rak'at, again there is no sitting in the middle after the second rak'ah or after the fourth or after the sixth, rather there is only one final sitting after the seventh rak'ah. And sometime he sallallahu alaihi wasallam would pray nine rak'at altogether. When he would pray nine rak'at, he would sit down after the eighth rak'ah. He would not sit down after the second or fourth or sixth. Rather, he would have the first sitting after the second rak'ah, after the eighth rak'ah. After the eighth rak'ah, he would read the tashahhud, and without taslim, without concluding, he would stand up for the ninth rak'ah, and then he would conclude the witr prayer altogether. Again, this is another sunnah that we should sometime try. Okay, if not in Ramadan, let's try outside the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq and ability to love our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because his love is part of our iman. We have to love him in order for us to complete our iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to love the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq and ability to follow the footsteps of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Innahu sami'un qareebun mujib. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.